Hello people, how are you? My name's Kev, this is Angling and Anxiety. It's all about the angling, obsessed about the anxiety.
Just to quickly document this, Nick has got motion sickness through being in the M25. We've got to go out in the wild Atlantic and get it, so fingers crossed.
Got tablets for that.
Just hit the Stonehenge point. That's halfway in my eyes. We're not halfway, but it is in my eyes. You know when you get to Stonehenge, you're nearly there. So, happy days. There she is, one of the wonders of the world. Top camera skills there, Nick.
I'm filming your camera.
Back in the room, people. Nick's having a little rest in her eyes.
Power nap, it's
cold. Power nap. we are getting out 1 o'clock. The time is 10 past 11. My watch has stopped. It is 10 past 11. My watch is telling me 10 past 7. It's definitely wrong. Lovely views. Look. Oh, no, it won't let me show you. But sun's shining. You can definitely tell you're getting down the southwest because of the weather. It is meant to be horrible weather tomorrow, but who cares, we're out here anyway. It's been a long old journey, to be honest. It's taken us through all kinds of country lanes and whatnot. Well, I'm not too sure why, but it's the quickest way on the sat nav, so we are just coming past Bodmin and Plymouth. In fact, I need to get over the lane. Right, so we are at Porth Kerris, somewhere fishing. Whose rod is going divvy down there? Honestly, look, we've been driving for 9 hours. Apparently, there's been tuna seen off of here today. Lots of bass, lots of pollock, all kinds of fish. This is at low tide, but honestly, super excited. Look, we can park right here as well, which is the best. Just walking across some nutty rocks. I love Cornwall, man. Absolutely adore it. We just paid a tenner to fish here and park the van. And it was an honesty box as well. It would have only actually cost us £8, but we thought we'd tip them £3 because they've had such a long day. Nick's a little bit tired. That looks tasty.
Look at the happiness on his face. I haven't been here 5 minutes. Look at that. Look at the colours on it.
Look at his mouth. It's all blue
in
there.
Hold it up more. Look at that. Show us your teeth. Look at the ganners on it. You can't really see them. But... Oh, well done, Kev.
Alright, so the tide is coming in, the flood as they call it. We was fishing sort of about here, but that's all over now. So we're waiting for the water to come in a little bit more. We're going to fish off these rocks or a bit further down there. Dinner served. Happy days. Look at the state of me. So wet, man. Nick's just done a bit of gutting. Fair play to the old boy, I wouldn't know where to start. Look at that. There's a humble abode in there, the bed and whatnot, but we've just got a tarpaulin up here that we can cook our sea bass. Proper innovation, look, bits of line coming off the rocks. Doing the job lovely. There's our dinner. Lovely bit. Happy days. Again, big shout out to Andy Al for sorting this out, still telling us where it is, do you know what I mean? Absolutely made a little trip it has. We come here in the expectation of catching a few whiting. When I pulled a wrasse in, I'll show you a picture in a minute. Honestly, so happy. So happy. We've had wrasse all different colours, sizes. Like, you would think that they'd come out of the Red Sea, some of them. It's unbelievable, the colours. Like, obviously, if you ran from round here, then it's not that fascinating, but for us bloody Chatham boys, it's wicked, man. Proper wicked. But we're going to have a bit of sea bass and some chilli, and we're going to get the rods back out, see what else we can catch. Might do a little bit of lure fishing around the rocks shortly. Got some sand eels. Nick's got some savage gear. Savage gear bass lures. I've got some rubber. Whoa! Nearly broke my leg and my neck and my back. But yeah, happy days. It's getting darker. I'll flick back to the food.
Chili. Garlic. Inside pan. Pay top money for this nice truck,
good. I could have shelter that. Proper this is, mate. Well, you can't see a lot of people, but we're out on the beach. Trying to show you the water. Look at that, man. Like I say, you can't see a lot, but honestly, man, we've had about 30 wrasse. We've had our sea bass dinner. We're having a lovely punt just for the sake of the fact we're here now, so we might as well be. We're going to change up the beach tomorrow.
There's Kev.
Get out, conger eel. Very little, but. Still, that's the third species we've had now. Happy days, mate. Now I'm buzzing again. Now I want to get the rod back out there.
Cush
day. He's on my own made rig as well, this one. None of them shot bought one. I kept having problems with them, so I made my own. Job's a good one. Right, so Nick's in. Been waiting a little while now. I've had a nil. What we got here, Nick? It is a bass. Get her up, boy. Yes! We got some moth food! Lovely! Get out of that! We're eating again!
Lovely bit.
One in the morning. I'm going to try for a few mackerel or something. It is in the colder months, but Andy seems to think we should be able to find some. So we're going to go and have a look down these rocks here. The stuff of there, he reckons there should be plenty. So we're going to have a go. Cornwall's the kind of place, like we left all of our fishing gear last night and outside our vans, and none of it was touched. if we'd have done that anywhere near where we lived, chances are we'd have gone walkers. It's just a different kind of place here, man.
Right, so day two, smashed the beach last night, had god knows how many wrasse, two sea bass, and a little baby congrel. Well, at least we think it was a congrel. We could be wrong, we're not sea fishermen. But it did have a good set of teeth on it. It did look like one that you catch out of fresh water.
And a big eye though, didn't it?
And a big eye. Yeah, so who knows, we could be wrong. Like we say, we're not professionals. We're now heading on to the next destination. Where that is, you may ask?
No.
Who knows? All part of the beauty. We ain't got a clue. Gonna go and take ourselves to Falmouth, go and find ourselves a supermarket, get some essentials, some oil, some water and stuff, and then go back into the wild. So, we'll catch you shortly. Right, so, we're walking along a coastal path. There's old Nick, somewhere in the back. There he is. Another little spot given to us by Andy. Good old man, what a man he is. Might be going out bass and ray fishing later on a boat, because shark fishing is looking like a write-off, unfortunately, due to strong winds and crazy tides. Don't really know about sea fishing, as you know, so I don't really know what it means, but all I know is it's not safe, or there's not much chance of catching a shark, so it's a blowout, but still a possibility. So yeah, get back to you when we're on the rocks. Alright guys, just have a look at this view, man. This is where we're headed. We just found it, just been walking. Absolutely knackered, but oh, look at that. Unbelievable. Let's hope we can get there, because we're going downhill. And we've missioned downhill, so who knows, but we'll soon find out. We're going on a little walk, a little wander. Just a fishing view there. Very basic. We don't need nothing else. Just going to see if we can get back on the beach.
I almost feel like jumping in, to be honest with you.
Beautiful, man. That's the old cliff we just walked along. Not too bad a walk after all. We've come from over here. So, happy days.
Check out the pool. So cool, man. Proper, proper cool.
Alright, we're on the rocks. The rods are out. Nothing yet. Nick's doing a bit of float fishing over there. He's got a little baby bait fish, live wrasse on one. That's a good sign over there. See him. He's jumping down and grabbing food. That means there's food there. It's a really, really fishy pool. Absolutely stunning, man. It's hard to believe we're in England sometimes. Never worse. Just sat here on the rocks, just chilling out. It's beautiful, man. Sun's out for once, which is nice. But yeah, out and about, wandering on cliffs. There's another fisherman over there. I don't know if you can see him. Just tucked up, doing a bit of lure fishing. I think that's what I'm going to do now. So hopefully we'll catch up with you shortly and have some fish to show you.
This is what happens when you're not an experienced fisherman, guys. Sea fisherman, you lose your gear, then crevices of rocks, and have to go and save it.
On the plus side, I've got it. So,
not all is lost. I've just lost a fish, which is annoying, over on the other rod, which is why this rod's ended up flying in.
Alright, so no big fish at the minute, but we had a couple of little baby bass, look at them.
Two bass.
Happy days. We're going to chuck them back. Go and ding them back, mate. Get them back in the water. Oh.
Go on, I'll walk them out there.
See that, my little fellow friend.
He's off.
Happy days. Double take.
That's a sign of good things, that is. Have a look at that, look. Beautiful, mate. I weren't a fan of sea fishing because I've never done it, but I'll tell you what, I'm in love.
The old carp rods are doing well, look at them. Admittedly, I did lose my line earlier, but I managed to retrieve it, which is handy for the environment and my tackle box. But yeah, tide's coming in at a rate of knots, located in St Michael's Mount. Cut the bass, little babies so far. Loving life at the minute, mate, honestly. Missing my family.
so is Nick. But enjoying it. Out tomorrow doing some multi-species fishing. I really, really want to catch a ray, that'd be cool. Don't know why, I just love Steve Irwin and don't know, just really want to catch a ray. But there you go. Let's try and catch some fish, eh?
Silly Kevin is got himself soaking wet.
Stupidly thought I had a pair of waders on or something. I didn't, I had a pair of wellies on. Waterproof over the top. Felt like waders. Until I went out into the water to cast and absolutely drenched myself. So I'm having a little bit of a change up, putting some new socks on. First time in 2 days, I ain't gonna turn that lies. Oh, pretty stink like an old polecat, but there you go.
Right, so we've got hungry. We haven't caught much. We caught a couple of baby bass, now too little to kill them and eat them. It wouldn't be fair, as hungry as we are. We haven't got much meat off them anyway. So I've had to come to McDonald's. It is what it is. We've got to eat. Not that it's going to fill us out because it's the worst food in the world, but it fills us out for a couple of hours, doesn't it? What we'll do is till tomorrow. I'm fading away. I feel weak and aggy. I get aggy when I'm hungry. Hangry. So I've got myself 20 chicken nuggets, a double cheeseburger, and a Coke and no ice. Winner, winner, McDonald's dinner. A little bit disappointing, but we did man yesterday and we've manned today, do you know what I mean? Lovely job, mate. Thank you. Thank you, mate. Have a good day, mate. Don't forget to subscribe to Angling and Anxiety. Oh, dear, I do make myself chuckle sometimes.
Here we have a wild Nick eating a McDonald's after nearly 24 hours without food.
I caught this. Oh, it wasn't lime,
sorry. Going to have a little change up. I've got squid on at the minute just because I'm trying to save my rag for tomorrow. I bought 200 of the barty little buggers. So, my own made rigs, my own made knots. Yeah, rag on there, but not much. So I'm going to chuck a new rag on there. Chuck a new rag on that one. Cut more fish. Got nil this time. Really little buggers, that. Got lime wrapped right on his head.
I'm going to have fun unhooking him.
Yep. A right 2 and 8, as they would say. But yeah, we've had a wicked, wicked 2 days. Pure exploring, adventuring, knackering stuff. Gonna stay out till about midnight tonight, catch something a little bit bigger. Yesterday was an absolute red letter day. Unbelievable amounts of wrasse, couple of nice size, or actually eating size, bass. One of them was about 45 centimetres, the other one was just over the limit, about 42 and a bit. Different kind of living down here, man. Everyone's so chilled. One day I will move down here. We're gonna start, I'm gonna start a sort of a trip at some point for other anglers who have got anxiety, who would like to go and do a drive and survive. We have had a McDonald's, but we've done well to sort of make it to the McDonald's level. Try and get some people a bit out of their shell. It'll do you the world of good. Oh, I've fallen all over the place. Do everyone a world of good. If you just got out, just got among the elements, and just sort of see what you're made of, really. Shows you the different side to yourself. Amazing buzz, crazy adrenaline. You can see by the look on my face when I caught that rash yesterday, just how happy I was. Right, couldn't believe it. We went there with the anticipation of not catching anything, maybe a couple of white and a pouting, and to be honest with you, we've caught plenty and no white and pouting, so. But I'm sure we'll get plenty of them tomorrow on the boat. Got a little trip planned with a good friend of mine, Reese, from the Fish Hunter UK. Check him out if I haven't already let you know. I dedicated my blue shark to him. Was good friends in school. Sort of lost touch over the years, as you do as you get older. Back in touch now doing the fishing. But yeah, check his channel out, Fish Hunter UK. Very, very, very intelligent sea angler. Knows exactly what he's up to.
But yeah, I'm going to be going out catching some rays with him soon. Been really, really successful. Absolutely blowing my mind for just how well it's gone, really. Could have gone completely tits up. Has nearly done a couple of times. Had a few little minor hiccups along the way. But everything's always sorted itself out in the end. Over the moon with it, really. It's been absolutely amazing. There's our room with a view up there. Deliberately reversed it up so when we wake up in the morning we can see the sea. It's been the nuts. Fingers crossed we get a couple more tonight. There's my reel with no line on it. The old Sonic Vaders, load of rubbish, but they've done me well. They really have done me well. Get the light up off the beach so we don't want to be getting any plastic in the ocean. Because old Uncle David Attenborough would have a guts for garters. And it's just the right thing to do anyway. But yeah, still got plenty of ragworm left for tomorrow. Bought myself a little black minnow lure earlier. Meant to be wicked. Had to cut the cast out and got snagged up. Wouldn't be Kevin if I didn't. But yeah, trip's been a 10 out of 10. Can't wait to do it again, really. Have missed the family, admittedly. Massively. But you've got to do these things in life sometimes, go on these adventures. Absence makes the heart grow fonder, as they say. But yeah, amazing. Amazing, 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 man. I'll be updating everyone with details about organising the trip. It won't be this year, it'll be next year. Just going to get a small group of anglers together with anxiety and other mental health issues. Just sort of get them out of their shell, do a bit of adventuring and sort of show them what a good life is about, really. Because I know a lot of people with anxiety struggle with social anxiety and things like that. Mate, you might not see me through my videos and stuff, but I suffer so badly with social anxiety. Nick does it also. Like me and Nick, when we first went fishing together, we'd have thought that in, I don't know, probably 9 months now, we'd have a little, we'd be going on fishing adventures and doing what we've done. And it's brought us both out of shells. We're really comfortable around each other now. Because it is hard work doing videos and trying to be yourself when you're with someone you know. It's hard. I can't even do it around my missus. I mean, I'm a lot more chilled with it now. She sort of gets it, you know what I mean? Doesn't like the fact that I'm absolutely addicted to fishing, but that's nothing to do with the videos. So yeah, it'd be good for people who've got social anxiety to get out of their shell. And just sort of, I want to make them feel comfortable. Oh, look at that. He didn't win the battle, did he? He's died in a natural way by the looks of it, because there's no marks on him or anything. Might have eaten something dodgily. But this is why you've got to get your plastic out of the ocean and look after the waters and look after the land, because animals are dying left, right and centre, unfortunately. And it's all down to human beings. So, I mean, that technically, let's have it right, I don't know how mate he's died, but fingers crossed it weren't due to something the human's done. Do enough to ruin this world. The one thing I've done since I've been down here is completely separate myself from I've had to do a bit of social media, but only positive stuff on the angling and anxiety and things like that on the page. If you haven't already liked it, like it. Angling and anxiety, there's plenty more footage on there. Done lots of live fishing videos, float fishing off the rocks, the wrasse. But I've distanced myself from all politics, anything that's negative really, anything that's going to make me feel horrible and negative. I'm just focusing on the good things, fishing, family, and being happy, really. So yeah, hopefully get a few more fish. That's about it. Been a nuts, Nick, innit?
All about the angling.
That's the one. That's the one. I don't look as cringy no more, though, as I did in that first video. Put a lot more in me, out of the show a little bit more. It's done me the world of good doing these videos, it really has. Yeah, thanks to all the supporters and that, and all my pals that watching that sympathy. I love you all. But yeah, I'll let you go. I won't bore you anymore. See if we can get some more fish, but probably see you in the morning when we're in the boat. Right, so it is 20 past 5 in the morning. So last day in Cornwall. Woke up absolutely freezing. I was snatched last night. Went to bed a little bit damp. Never a good idea. Not when you got the doors open. Good to get away on our way to Falmouth. And say our goodbyes to St. Michael's Mount.
and go get out of this boat. So let's go.
We're off. Over 5 metres of water in a minute. Sun's coming up. Nick's not been sick yet.
Hey.
We're out here.
Keep that bend in that rod. I think this is angling anxiety's finest moment right now. Tuna team. Team tuna.
He's there.
Keep going. You nearly got it. Left.
Fuck you, yeah, now. Jesus Christ. Fucking hell!
Oh, jeez! Oh, my God, man! Oh, my fucking God!
There she goes! Yes!
Mate, I've never been so buzzing in my life. Oh, my legs are like jelly, my back hurts.
Beautiful, man. Look at him.
Nick's at battle. Don't know what we're at the minute. It's going under the boat. Ian. Probably Ian.
Right, you've got each other. You let mine out. You let mine out. There is a fish on there somewhere. Fuck you now. Oh, yeah, there's a fish on there. I think it's all your gear is here as well.
Yeah.
Fucking hell, this is. That's just a weight. Bring that up.
Yep.
Oh no, I got a fucking cold here. Yeah.
Hand line.
I'm gonna have to hand line.
That's off.
You're fucking awful.
Everyone's hooked on. Everyone's all.
It's a group fish.
Yeah.
Literally, everyone caught that.
Thanks to the conga. Yeah, that's it. Oh,
yeah,
that's it. I don't mess about it. No, honestly, this phone's worth more than my life. He's dragging his feet, mate, I tell you. It's still there, though.
where the conger decides he's going to chuck himself back in his hole. We'll keep seeing if we can let him have a little minute of resting, see if he worms his way back out, and then the battle commences.
Just having some fresh crab in the limit.
Lovely little tenner around the alpha, look.
You're going to
eat the name, didn't you? Yeah. Tuna today, was there? Yeah. I love this fucking place, I swear to God. Look at him, mate. So that monster.
Seafood
delivered
straight to your door.
You want to get done by them pincers, would you?
No.
Of him. Well, people, that was eventful. I haven't really stopped smiling, to be honest with you. We haven't stopped watching videos and pictures. Mad turnout. Still can't believe my luck, to be honest with you. Out there looking for freshers. And could we get a tuna? But madness, really is madness. Throughout the trip, you've seen we've had wrasse, bass, hayating, whiting, mackerel. What else have we had? Conger eels. Babies to things that are longer than bloody us, really. Absolute units. It's been amazing, man. It's been an amazing 3 days. I don't even know what to say anymore, I really don't. We're on our way home now, we're about halfway there, and it's just been unbelievable. Angling and anxiety, as he likes to do, has absolutely smashed it out of the water, man. I feel like we deserve it. We've got a lot of research in. I've spent a few quid trying to make it happen, so has Nick. Both properly dedicate ourselves to it, as we always do with anything fishing related. Had some really positive messages of people. There's a lot of footage on the Facebook page, Angling and Anxiety. So check that out as well. I don't know if you follow me on Instagram, check that out. Don't forget to subscribe, because this is just one of many ventures we've got coming. And it will always be madness. Being positive, being negative, they're going to be worthy. It's definitely worth subscribing. You haven't got to have a YouTube account or anything like that. All you've got to do is have an email address, that's it. Just go into the bit who asks you to sign in when you click subscribe. Type in your email address. Job's good, that's it. I really appreciate it. All you could just to sort of... It's more... I don't get paid for this. This isn't about money. This is about... I don't know. It's about gratitude, and it's about... feeling worthy, really, and just feeling like we're doing something good in the world. Like I said previously, we're going to try and get a trip arranged. We did bow to McDonald's last night, but we deserved a McDonald's at the end of the day. We couldn't live on two seabass, it was as simple as that. We just couldn't. We could have done if we really needed to, but at the end of the day, we didn't want to be tearing each other's heads off. We needed to eat, and we needed to be prepped up for today's boat trip. Glad we did, really. Glad everything's gone the way it went.
Be nice to go home and have a shower.
Shave. 3 days going hard. The quality's a bit bad in this because it's night time now. And we're driving home. And we've got a little internal light on, so.
It's small.
Yeah, it's not going to be. It's literally small.
I look like
a kid.
You look like you're my dad.
It's okay, son. Yeah, no. You've enjoyed it, we certainly have. I've tried to cram as much footage in. I haven't done the edit on this video because, one, I want it to be good. I don't want to miss bits out and stuff like that. And it needed to be right, do you know what I mean? So I've had some of the majority of the editing. I've done quite a bit. I've had done final touches and stuff. Like always, we are just completely ourselves. We're not trying to be, I look like I'm trying to be anything, but I'm not. I'm certainly not. We're just out here for the crack, really. And just trying to make awareness for mental health and just how much angling helps it, really. I've never smiled like I smile when I caught that wrasse
As you can see, I love this sighted schoolboy, and what a place Cornwall is, man. Get yourself out to Cornwall if you can, if you haven't already. It's where my heart belongs. It's now where Nick's heart belongs. But yeah, man, happy days. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe, please. And I hope you enjoyed it, man. Catch up with you in the next video. A little motto. Fingers crossed we're not needed this weekend. It was not even a weekend, it's a week. I like to take a week of work and strength and everything. Lots of week's money. There you go. Love it. Worth every penny. Thanks again.